Hi and welcome back. This time we're configuring the date picker for use on the worksheet text boxes for professional reporting. Let's turn our focus on the report worksheet. As you have noticed, this entire workbook is a fake. However, I have created it to give you a glimpse of what a professional spreadsheet may look like. There is a series entitled Professional Spreadsheets coming after the date picker series. Please stay tuned for that one. What you see here is just a glimpse. Like the date picker series, I will teach you how to build and design professional reports, and I will guide you with care and you will learn everything step by step. Now back to this report. This is a typical report you can find in any offices. It analyzes information from these two worksheets based on what is selected at the top. For now, we manually type in the dates and everything works. However, if I make one mistake and type the date wrong, my report will be distorted. Besides, capturing dates this way is a waste of time and there is no fun at all. Let's fix that by adding a date picker. The worksheet text boxes are similar to the user form text boxes with a slight difference. Thanks to our date picker, the integration uses the same approach. However, our target events are the got focus and the change event. Let's start by binding the date picker to this date text box. To do this, I must first switch to design mode. We are switching to design mode because unlike the user form text boxes, these are worksheet text boxes and were designed using this toolbox. So they are called ActiveX controls. Now click on the design mode, select and double click on the text box and then find the got focus event from the drop down list. Next, to call the date picker, I must write launch date picker and then hit the space button. The next field is for specifying whether we need a date picker or a time picker. For now, let's pretend that this report is for purchases only, meaning we need a date picker. So for the date only parameter, I can select true or skip it because it defaults to true. Let's not skip it. Select true, place a comma, then write me dot and then select the text box. This is very important. On the worksheet text boxes, you must specify the target text box the same way you do with the icons. So this will call the date picker when you click directly into the text box. Let's find out. Perfect. This works very well. Now let's call the date picker on the change event in case our user decides to manually change the date. To do this, I will double click again on the text box. Find the change event and then write the same code I wrote on the got focus event. Now, if the user enters the date and then tries to change the date, our date picker will be rendered to the user. The last thing we need to do is to launch the date picker when the user clicks on the icon. Now, because this is a shape or a picture, we must assign a macro to it. So in this worksheet module, I must create a sub-procedure specifically for this text box. I will put it just below the two events we just created. It is always best to name the procedure using the name of the target text box and then specify that it's an icon. This will guide you when assigning the macro. So within the sub, I will also write the same code I wrote on the GodFocus and change event. You see, the integration is very simple. What I can do now is to assign a macro to the icon, and that completes the integration. Now, our date picker is fully configured to this date text box. Please go ahead and follow the same procedure we used on this text box to bind the date picker to the next text box. When done, your report should function like this.